Hello. In this video, we will learn about creating custom components in QML. To begin, I have created an empty Qt Quick application in Qt Creator. Custom components allow us to define a new reusable QML object type in our program. This object type is typically defined in a separate QML file where the name of the file is the desired name of the type. The QML file is then automatically recognized by the engine as a definition of a QML type. A type defined in this manner is automatically made available to other QML files within the same local directory, although it is possible to have types defined in other directories. To create our custom component example, we will create a new QML file by right-clicking on the project and selecting Add New. We'll select Qt in the Files and Classes pane, and QML file in the middle pane. This will prompt a new QML file creation wizard. Here, we need to specify the name. The file name will determine the name of our custom component. It is important to note that the first letter of this file name must be a capital letter for the component to work correctly. I will name the QML file My Component. Below the name, you can specify if you wish to have the QML file exist in another directory. For this component, I'll use the project directory. In order to use this custom component in our main QML file, we need to add it to our cmakelist.txt file in the Qt Add QML Module section. Here, I will type in the name of our custom component QML file. I'll save that. And we can see it appear in our project view on the left. We can use my component just like any other built-in Qt Quick component. I'll switch over to my main.qml, and we can see here that when I type my component, Qt Creator will see it and color code it correctly. Before we define my component, let's add another custom component created in a subdirectory. To do that, we will follow the same creation process by right-clicking on the project and selecting Add New. We'll select QML file again, and this time we will name it My Other Component. We can specify here the path in which My Other Component will exist, so we'll select the MyDir directory, which I have already created. We'll add the QML file to the project by selecting the project name and clicking Next. Again, we'll need to add the QML file to the cmakelist.txt file. It is possible to share custom QML types within a project by defining them within a custom module as well. The method demonstrated in this example is a simpler way of adding custom types to our project, but for larger projects or more complex custom types, defining a module may be the ideal method. There is additional information about QML modules included in the description of this video for those who would like to look into this more. In this case, we will need to add the subdirectory path. I'll add that now. I'll navigate over to main QML. Before we use this custom component in our main.qml, it is best to import the directory in which the custom component exists so Qt Creator recognizes the component in our main.qml. So, at the top of the main.qml, we will add the following. Do note this import statement needs to be in quotes. Now Qt Creator will register my other component as a usable component within our main.qml. We can now define our components. First, we will define my component, so we'll head over to mycomponent.qml. To keep it simple, we'll create a rectangle object, and inside of that rectangle, we'll create another circular rectangle. These objects together will represent the definition of a my component, which can be reused throughout the program. First, I'll add an ID, height, and width to the item container, which will hold our rectangles. Then I'll create a rectangle, which will be the size of item. I'll give it an ID, a color, and a height and a width. Now, inside that rectangle, we'll add our circular rectangle. I'll give this an ID, a color, a height and width, and a radius. Now we can go back to main.qml and use these components. I'll click on main.qml here. First, we'll make an item object to hold our custom components. We'll center it in the window and give it a height and width. We can now use our custom My component just like any other component in QML. Let's add My component to the item. Although we cannot change properties inside the component from main.qml, we can add some additional properties to this instance of my component. The properties which can be defined at this level are those which are inherited from the item component. I'll add an ID to this my component. I'll run the program now, and we can see our custom component appear in the center of the window. Another benefit to using custom components in QML is that we can define custom properties and custom signals with signal handlers. Let's do this in my other component. I'll switch back over to my other component.qml so we can implement this. We'll make this very similar to my component by creating a rectangle inside of an item. Let's add an ID, height, and width to the item. And some properties for a rectangle. Let's add this simple example to our main.qml. I'll switch over to main.qml now. We'll add a My Other Component object within the item. We'll want this instance of the My Other component to display just below our other object, so we'll add an anchor to it, as well as an ID. Now, if we run the program, this will display our My Other component right below our My component. Now that we've got My Other component set up, let's add some custom properties and signal handlers to it. I'll go back to my My Other component.qml to implement this. Custom properties allow for variables to be exposed outside of the component. Properties can be declared as common variable types such as int, double, string, or more complex properties such as list properties or color. These properties must be declared at the top level of the component. Otherwise, they will not be accessible outside of the component. We're going to add a custom string property and create a text object that displays the string. So, at the top level of my other component, we will add the following line. This creates an empty string variable in our My Other component called label. This is accessible outside of the component. We need to have some way to display this property, so we'll create a simple text object inside of the rectangle. We will print the value of label here. And since we can access this label outside of the component, we'll set the value in main.qml. I'll go back to main.qml now. In main.qml, we can directly set the label property inside of my other component. So we'll add the following line. Now we can run this program and see text within my other component displaying data from our custom string property. Lastly, we'll head back to my other component.qml to create a custom signal and signal handler. Signals and signal handlers are used to expose custom functionality outside of the component. Custom signals can be emitted directly from outside of the component. First, we can define a custom signal that can be emitted from main.qml. This also must be done at the top level of the component. We'll call ours custom clicked. We will also define a signal handler that will execute when custom clicked is emitted. This must be called on custom clicked. All signal handlers must follow this naming convention with on followed by the capitalized signal name. We can give this some functionality. We'll have it change the text in my other component. That's all we need to do in my other component. Now we can go to main and emit the signal. We'll emit the signal whenever my component is clicked. To do that, we'll just add a mouse area which fills the space of my component, and we'll have the onClicked signal handler emit our custom clicked signal. That is all we need to do to work with custom signals and signal handlers. I'll run the program and we can see, when I click on my component, the text below in my other component will change. So, our signal handler has been run. That covers the basic concept of custom components. For more information, please explore the documentation in the description. If you ran into any problems throughout this tutorial, please feel free to create a support ticket through your Qt account, and we will be sure to help resolve your issue. Thank you.